Welcome back to Let's Play Mass Effect Andromeda. I'm the RPG Chick. This episode, we're probably the entire episode is just going to be checking out the different systems that have popped up. At least I'm hoping I can make an episode out of it. Otherwise, I don't know what I'm tacking on the end, some research or something maybe. Alright. Well, let's tackle these systems down here, relatively, anyway. Togessan. Engage. Might pick up some quests. Who knows?
Very little signal traffic around.
It's pretty remote.
It is.
I wonder what view of the Milky Way you'd get out here.
Unknown.
Anomaly on sensors.
We got an anomaly and we got four planets. Let's start with the innermost planet. Wioji? As is my rule, I don't skip the first time I go to a new planet. Or thing. Repeat voyages, I'll tab and skip it. Surveys from the Milky Way suggested Wioji might contain vast mineral wealth just beneath its surface. On closer examination, no such deposits exist. Wah wah.
Anomaly on sensors.
Next, second planet from the sun, Garaf. That's actually one of my favorite parts of the game. Very relaxing. I love reading about the planets, I just wish the descriptions were as long as in the Mass Effect 1 through 3. Beneath the planet's crushing argon-based atmosphere, microbial lifeforms are flourishing on Garaf or Garaf in and around underground pools.
Anomaly detected.
We'll get to that. Third planet on the sun. Balloon? Balloon? I don't know how to pronounce these names. This is crazy stuff. Named for an early Angaran explorer who perished on Balloon's surface, this rocky world commands a quiet respect from the Angaran people.
Anomaly on sensors.
Fourth and last planet, Paz 31, and then we'll check out the anomaly on sensors. Cool. I like that through the debris field like that. Tiny ring. Or rings. Ocean plains of frozen ammonia dominate the surface of Paz 31, climbing into icy mountains along the rims of ancient craters. Togessan. Forgot to say the name. Alright, let's see what
anomaly on sensors.
Yes, yes. What anomaly do you have? Over here?
Deploying probe. I found something.
I found something. I found an asteroid. Check it out. That's me. Stuff bouncing harmlessly off of our shields. M-type asteroid, diameter 823 kilometers, surface gravity 0.02 g's. Not much of gravity at all. Fragments of remnant technology are buried on this asteroid, nearly unrecognizable after centuries of disuse. Some XP.
Anomaly detected.
Oh, got another one?
Probes launched. Got a reading from the asteroid belt.
Ooh, starship wreckage. Awesome. Let's check it out. Yeah, if it's all like this, I could definitely have enough for an episode's worth. Well, not much left of that starship. Ship identity unknown. Ship name unknown. Crew complement unknown. Estimate 5 through 8. Status not available. This appears to be the wreckage of a Ket dropship. Perhaps they were seeking remnant technology in the asteroid belt? We got a bunch of crap. Okay. Any more anomalies? Still picking up stuff?
Anomaly detected.
You're kidding. How many anomalies in this place?
Probes launched. Tracking a huge mineral deposit.
Cool. Got a lot of stuff in here. Ouch. That rock hit me right in the face. G-type asteroid. Diameter 2,323 kilometers. Surface gravity 0.04 g's. A little bit more. This massive asteroid is the size of a small moon. It could serve as a perfect base for future scientific and mining expeditions into the asteroid belt. I got 139 aluminum. Okay. Anything else? No more anomalies, you sure? Okay. Alright, let's check out the Dar'Hegah system.
They named the system after a Batarian pioneer. Their first astronaut.
Oh, really?
It's good to remember these things.
Batarians didn't come with us.
The
Batarians didn't come with us, though. So another system with four planets. Let's check on the innermost planet, Jagraph. The way we're approaching it is weird, huh? Oosh. Sometime in the past century, Jagraph was impacted by a very large or very fast object, natural or artificial, that cracked open its mantle and caused a continuing series of quakes. Okay.
Anomaly on sensors.
Second planet, H505. This one has double the rings, baby. Huh.
I'm picking up something.
That's spiral at the end. Hidden from early surveys by reflective objects in Dar'Hegah's asteroid belt, H505 is a frigid world with a krypton nitrogen atmosphere. Come on, there you go. Oh, right in there.
Probes launched.
In that crater.
We've got a crater.
Yes, we've got a crater. Hypervelocity impact crater, largest. Rim diameter 402 kilometers. Depth approximately 2.1 kilometers. Ejecta. Mineral deposits, heavy metals. This is the largest of multiple impact craters, suggesting a swarm of debris, possibly from the asteroid belt, struck H505 in the distant past. Got some experience. Just finding that crater made us smarter. Isn't that cool?
Anomaly detected.
Third planet from the sun, Nagral. Looks like Earth. Sort of. With more ice. Nagral's crushing atmosphere is toxic and violent. Its density makes scans difficult. The planet's rings appear to be of relatively recent origin, possibly related to the Scourge. Okay, well, it kind of looks like Earth, but you definitely would not want to live there. Atmospheric pressure is 101.68 atmospheres. Crazy.
Anomaly detected.
That actually is way too heavy, even for the crap. Oh, I can't remember the name. Not the Volus. It's on the tip of my tongue. I hate when I can't remember names that I actually do know. I can remember everything else. Volus, Hanor, something with E. Oh my god, I hate that. Alright, let's go to Dinesh, last planet. Crap. Looks like the moon. Dinesh. Cobalt and nickel form the outer layer of Dinesh's crust. Scans suggest the planet is far less tectonically stable than it appears. The Elcor. I knew it started with an
anomaly detected.
Alright, anomaly. Next to the giraffe, kinda.
Probe away. Got a reading from the asteroid belt.
Cool. Oh, vessel. Check it out. Cool. Another cat vessel. Classification, Cat Scout. Structural integrity 68%, life signs none. This Cat Scout vessel appears to have been abandoned in the asteroid belt after an engine failure. Its aimless drifting among the asteroids has resulted in significant damage, but some materials may be salvageable. It would be cool if we find some... if we ever could find something like this, and like, there's unconscious cat and we can extract them and then keep them as prisoner, bring them back to the Nexus, what have you. Bunch of scrap. That should be it. We're 100% here. Dar'Hegah. So Dar'Hegah and Togessan. And we've got Kindrax. I'm just looking at this because I want to write this stuff down. Dar'Hegah. Togessan. Okay.
I studied Kindrax's theories. A real Turian aeronaut.
Oh, cool.
The first to cross the ocean in a balloon.
On Paladin? Brave soul. There aren't many soft places to land.
I'm making up something.
That's Kindrax. I just want to look at something. Because I think I spelled this wrong. Togessan. toe. Sorry guys, I'm just writing this down to make it easier for me to actually write up the description later. Wait. How do I go back? I'm already there. This is Zarbray. I am here. Right, okay.
I'm picking up something.
Okay, so we got 5 planets? Or 4? Wait. It looks like 4, but I see 5 rings. We got this one, and we've got this one going around, and then what's on this? Oh no, I've got 4 rings. Okay, never mind. Let's start with the innermost planet, H073. So Kindrax was a Turian. That's a cool name. Out of all the new system names, I think that's my favorite, Kindrax. The kin of Drax the Destroyer. Constant volcanic activity brings magma to the surface of H073, where it gradually solidifies in the scorching heat. Okay.
I'm picking up something.
Short but sweet. Second planet from the sun is Mendradim? Mendradim. So funny. Now that we're all focused on going to Meridian, like, we should go there. I'm really gonna do everything but until there's nothing left to do. The Scourge has torn away most of Mendradim's atmosphere, leaving ravaging electrical storms above and wasted plains below. Mere traces of plant life remain on the surface.
Anomaly on sensors.
Third planet? Tun-Harriset? No idea how you really say these names. I'm assuming they're all, you know, what do you call it? They're all Turian names. Traces of remnant and Ket technology are present on the planet, obscured by the warping effects of nearby Scourge. There was something here. It has since been removed. Well, guess we can't find it if it's been removed. Share the last planet.
I'm picking up something.
H202. Cool, I like this one.
Anomaly on sensors.
Sweet. Nicknamed Gorgeous by the science team, H202 has a surface composed mainly of tin and boron. Traces of organic life are present in its rings. They may have been formed from a destroyed satellite.
Launched. Getting a scan.
Cool. More starship wreckage. Same ship identity and name unknown. Crew complement unknown. Status not available. This debris appears to be from an initiative shuttle. Pieces of powerful scanning equipment drift among shards of hull. Now we got more scrap. She's gonna find another anomaly, I think. Oh, that's right. We haven't explored the one anomaly actually in the system itself. Funny how we can go back to these places.
Anomaly on sensors.
This is gonna be probably a one anomaly. This thing? Okay.
Deploying probe.
It's gotta be like outside
the
system.
What's left of a ship.
It's like outside the system. Just outside. Got stuck. Crashed among the Scourge. Apparently. And we're gonna get dangerously close to it. So what exactly is it made out of, the Scourge? Kind of radioactive material? It's almost like plant life. Again, ship identity and name unknown, status not available, crew complement zero, assumed. This remnant fighter appears to have been caught in a tendril of Scourge and utterly torn apart. And we got a bunch of crap. Too bad we don't find any- oh, sorry guys. Too bad we don't find anything really useful. We always just find scrap with this starship wreckage. Oh yeah. Now we're done with Kindrax. Now, Faross. Oh, watch out, Scourge!
The light on the side of this cluster is so different. Maybe the Scourge is absorbing certain wavelengths.
Does it ever give anything back?
Probably not.
Detected.
Anomaly detected. Okay. So... again. That's probably the anomaly there. Four planets. All these systems have four planets. Coincidence? Or no? H028 is the innermost planet. A near-constant bombardment of meteorites from the nearby asteroid belt pelts the surface of H028. Its only real weather is the resulting dust clouds. Okey-doke.
Anomaly on sensors.
Second planet from the sun is Aphaja? Aphaya? I don't know. And Garen J is sometimes pronounced as a ja, and sometimes like jal, and sometimes it's like a y. It's like a ya sound. Kind of similar to Skyrim names. Thanks to its unusual orbit and axial tilt, Aphaja is pounded by snow and howling winds for all but a few hours of each 56-hour day.
Up something.
Well, if people live there, they can go outside, well, sometimes. Grill. Don't be grilling me. This might end up being a long episode, guys. I do want to tie up all these solar systems in one episode. Just for the people who don't want to watch it, they can easily skip.
Anomaly on sensors.
Cool. First discovered by an outcast with an unusual sense of humor, Grill was named for its extremely hot metallic surface and earmarked for future mining operations. Deploy probe. Right there.
Probe away. Getting a scan.
Volcano. Active volcanic site. Profile. Scoria cone with current explosive eruption. Lava composition, comatite, there's two eyes there, comatite flow with unknown materials. The lava flow from this volcano has annihilated an unmanned outcast monitoring post leaving equipment scattered and buried. Outcast decided to just monitor things from here. So got some experience. Okay. Now we've got probably a few anomalies.
Anomaly on sensors.
Oh, we got one more planet to look at, actually. Asiak. Fourth and final planet from the sun. Unless there's a hidden one, that's actually an anomaly. Probably not.
Anomaly on sensors.
SEX thick carbon dioxide and argon atmosphere shows symptoms of scourge distortion, though no scourge tendrils are detectable in the planet's current orbital path. They had a different path? You're gonna find scourge down here? Oh, I see. Above the planet?
Probes launched. Detecting what's left of a ship.
Correct. Satellite. Satellite ID unknown. Power readings 43.9%. System report. Primary instruments damaged. Backups functional. Status operational. This CAT satellite is rapidly processing data on the atmosphere of Asiak, though it has been badly damaged by the planet's storms. 60 research Helios data. Or Helios research data. Okay.
Anomaly detected.
Now, what's your anomaly?
Probes launched.
That's what I was looking at.
Getting a scan.
Asteroid. I knew that was it. A-type asteroid, diameter 854 kilometers, surface gravity 0.02 g's, like the other one we found. This gargantuan asteroid is clearly being used as a stopover by outcasts. A small, empty supply post and docking station were built into the rock. Got some experience. And that's it for Faross, 100%. How many do we have left? We have Skeldah, Remav. Oh, we did Remav. Never mind. And Shojaon. Two? Okay. Yeah, two more. All right. Skeldah. Skeldah, here we come. What the hell is a Skeldah? Besides a solar system.
This is one of the most remote systems in the cluster. We're on the brink.
Exciting, cool. Isn't it?
Ah. We got actually five planets. Okay. Let's check out H329. We'll go from the outermost planet. Just to change things up. Scourge has stripped away much of H329's atmosphere, leaving it unable to retain heat. Its liquid nitrogen oceans are now entirely frozen. Well, it is pretty far from the star. No anomaly on sensors, huh? H061. Looks like they have no names for these planets. They just give it a letter and some numbers. It's all H, I guess, for Helios, right? Then what's the PAS stand for? P-A-S. PAS reckon? H-061's orbital velocity slows as the planet passes near tendrils of scourge, radically extending its total orbital period in ways difficult to calculate. Okay. Norgraqua. It's hard to even say. Norgraqua. A windy, frigid desert, Norgraqua is deemed for a mythological Asari penal colony. Even with protective gear, it's unlikely anyone could survive here for long. Well, it's a desert, but temperature is negative 117 Celsius. Alright. No anomalies so far on any of these planets. Second planet from the sun, Cut Cobra. Got some crazy names here. I miss the names that were named after, like, I don't know, gods of different cultures. Like you'd have, like, every solar system would have, like, a theme.
Anomaly detected.
We got an anomaly on this one. Unlike the nearby world of Bleeding Ruby, Cut Cobra appears to have been in a state of ongoing volcanism for millennia. Gases released by this activity pervade the atmosphere. And what do we find here?
Probes launched. Tracking a huge mineral deposit.
Cool. Beryllium. A metal ideal for lightweight construction and a variety of applications. This deposit is readily accessible. Then let's access it. Got 53 beryllium. That's it. Bleeding Ruby, yeah, this is the innermost planet. I know how to say that word, or words, rather. So there's that. I guess it's ruby because it's so red, because it's close to the sun, and it's bleeding because, well, I guess volcanic stuff happening. Named by an exile with a penchant for poetry, Bleeding Ruby's rings and tectonic instability are the result of a single asteroid impact that occurred less than a century ago. Okay, so I have a question about that. The exile named it Bleeding Ruby. These names are... I like the sun back there, the star. That's hard to control... That's bright. So, an exile named this planet. And, who told us this? And why is the initiative saying, okay, exile, we'll let you call it Bleeding Ruby? It's just, I don't know. It's weird. It doesn't even matter. That's probably why they just accepted the name. Doesn't matter. Okay, our last system? Guess so. Yeah, everything else. It would have the what do you call it? Just double checking a few of these. That's that progression there. Yeah, I guess that's it. So I gotta make sure we're not missing an exclamation mark. Shojaon. Shojaon. Final system. we can call it an episode here.
This place is almost off our star charts.
Mm. Considering what they were up against, your explorers made it a long way out.
Wow, cool. Look at the spiral arm. It, like, are we seeing a galaxy beyond this? Oh wow, and that last planet is so far off. Five planets. Alright, we'll go from the innermost now, because I'm really interested in this planet, so I'm going to save it for last. Paz 21. Glad there's no Reapers dogging us. Remember that in Mass Effect 3. With its light gravity, silvery coloration, and scorching daytime temperatures, Paz 21 bears a passing resemblance to Earth's moon. The debate over what to name it will be fierce. Why? I guess the names do matter. So why is what the Exile names it becomes canon? Paz 24. Oh, it's Paz Reckon, not Paz Reckon. So what does Paz mean? I'm sure it stands for something. I just don't know what.
Anomaly detected.
Cool. Paz 24's hot surface is composed primarily of magnesia, with notable sodium deposits. Geographic features suggest the planet once possessed oceans. How this is possible is unknown.
Deploying probe. I found something.
The unknown knows. It's a crevasse. Length 555 kilometers. 555. Average width 47 kilometers. Maximum height 3 kilometers. This extraordinary canyon runs long and deep. Hundreds of small caves lead underground. Although this crevasse may be natural, it is currently inexplicable. Yeah, we can't explain things on this planet, huh? Got some experience. That's it. I guess there are no planets that have two anomalies. Alright, third planet is Fen Odam. Massive uranium deposits are commonplace on Fen Odam. It is one of the few planets the Angara have charted in this system, though they have yet to begin mining. Well, you better get to it. Well, the initiative will beat you to it. Alright, so... fourth planet from the sun. Paz 48. So, yep, I guess Paz is the... something in the Angaran language. Look at this planet.
Anomaly detected.
Cool. It looks awesome. Spectacular auroral effects flash through Paz 48's magnetosphere over a temperate, mineral-rich surface. Only the lack of liquid water makes it inappropriate for colonization. Are you serious? Those look mostly water. What's all this? That looks like water to me.
Probe away. Tracking a huge mineral deposit.
Copper. A large metal deposit. Copper is a noble metal whose high conductivity makes it useful for a variety of purposes. We found 64 of it. Hmm. I wonder what that is, though, because it looks like liquid water to me. Even this last planet, very remote. Okay. One of the two planets to have a name. Mokalam. Mokalam. Tiny gas planet at the edge of the Shojaon system, Mokalam is a perfect location for exploring ships to restock helium-3 and discharge the static buildup in their drives. Very cool. That's it, we are 100%. No systems outstanding at this point. It looks like we'll definitely have one here, here. Possibly here, as well here, here, and here, and here. It's like a box here, you know, of systems that you could have. And probably one here. Huh. Did I look at these three as well? Sheesh. There's a black hole in the middle. Okay. Done. Not completely sure what our next episode will be, but hope to see you guys then. Thanks so much for watching, and enduring, cross strong.